are going on a Father's Day adventure. I'm hoping Eric will be surprised and happy with what I have planned tonight. He has hopefully zero idea of what we're doing. And yeah, hoping it's gonna be fun. We are in downtown Seattle and just parked. And I think he knows what we're doing, but I'm not 100% sure because he's being very nice about it. But I still hope he likes it. Do you know what we're doing?
Maybe.
You have a slight idea?
Maybe.
Are you happy about it?
Maybe.
This is not helping me at all. We're going in. What'd you get?
Got a Captain America lanyard.
He's actually pretty cute. He's very cute. Cool.
Marvel's iconic characters have thrilled fans in every form of media. But where did it all start? The story of Marvel really begins 80 years ago at a small, quirky New York publishing company. It's here on 42nd Street that a small group of creators first lights the spark of the Marvel Universe. The 1940s would later be known as the Golden Age of comics, with no competition from TV, video games, or the internet. They are enormously popular. In the aftermath of the war, superheroes have been taken over by crime and horror comics, which have parents concerned. By the early 50s, the controversy over comic books becomes a full-blown panic. Comic book burnings are even held around the USA, under the editorship of his nephew, Stan Lee Niebuhr, better known to the world today as Stan Lee. Frustrated with comics' uncertain future, Stan thinks about quitting the business. His wife, Joan, urges him to do one more comic book on his own terms before giving up. Stan turns to Jack Kirby, one of the most imaginative visual storytellers in the history of comics. Working together, they develop a new kind of superhero team, the Fantastic Four. In 1961, the debut of the Fantastic Four heralds the dawn of the Marvel Age of superheroes. The book receives more fan mail than any other Marvel publication that month. Stan and Jack know they have a hit. Inspired by this success, the two embarks on an astounding burst of creativity over the next 2 years, giving audiences the Incredible Hulk, the Mighty Thor, the Invincible Iron Man, Ant-Man and the Wasp, and the Uncanny X-Men. And one day, in the summer of 1963, when the first issue of Daredevil isn't going to make the deadline, Stan and Jack realize that they could bring their solo characters together to form a whole new team. They call them the Avengers. The Marvel Universe is such a powerful, imaginative concept that versions of it can now be found in every storytelling medium humans have devised. The Marvel Cinematic Universe has drawn millions of people to theaters around the world. Now, for the first time, the history of the evolution brings these incredible superheroes together in one place.
Thank you.
First Marvel comics ever made.
Nice.
But Human Torch is an android. It's not the same Human Torch as your head has before.
Oh.
Possible, good grammar shall be employed.
I love that.
This guy! Woo! It's
kind of creepy but cool.
Ah, oh, so cool.
Holy cow.
I don't know.
Yeah,
it's
like
I
want to like. Do you want to ruin the photo?
No.
Hers is like cool and like so intricate. All of her.
And Gwen Stacy takes his place.
You think it's like made of nylon?
I can play you right now.
Huh?
So.
Oh.
Hers.
Yeah.
Is spandex, nylon, polyester, leather.
There's a tattoo, like you can see all that.
Leather, metal, yeah. Trousers are spandex. Black Panther is nylon and polyester.
Nice. Yeah.
His helmet's just plastic.
I can totally see that.
Hers is spandex, nylon, and polyester. Her skirt is
blue. Oh, I just noticed her little... I didn't realize they were kitties.
The Panthers.
I didn't realize that in the movie.
Her thing had teeth on it.
Yeah, I didn't realize any of that in the movie. I just have cool feet. Ah, there's so much glare.
Yeah, I'm coming.
Ha, I knew it. Fancy shoes.
Like the female version. That looks huge. No, I know it is. I just didn't realize how huge her helmet was. She looks like Black Panther.
So this is from
so thick.
This is from the Dark World.
Yeah.
This is from Avengers 1. That's obviously Ragnarok.
It's Mew Mew! Looks heavy. Whoa. That's pretty big too. I found Ant-Man. So tiny, like I knew he was tiny, but I just didn't realize he was like tiny, 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 tiny. The wasp. Is the wasp in here, or is it just him? She's so tiny. Holy cow! I was about to ask, I was like, are these the same things from...
I don't know if they're from the same place, but...
This was like the original, right? This was like the original? And then this was like the second one that he made?
Yeah.
One,
and three. Fancy. And the arc reactor.
Suitcase for what?
From Iron Man 2?
What does it do?
Turns him into Iron Man.
Oh.
Soldier. Oh. He has the metal arm. I saw Falcon over there and said it.
Oh.
Bucky.
Wait a second. There are two shields.
Teleports you. So like, you tell him where to go, you touch him, and he teleports you somewhere.
Huh.
Lockjaw. He's an inhuman. He's the inhuman stuff.
Excelsior. I don't know if I pronounced that right.